Hello, Lock Jockey here. I've got a West 916 I'm going to try to pick for you. It's a 12-pin dimple lock. Come on. Okay. And open. Don't want to go too far past certain degrees, because I'll just keep dumping my pins in the keyway. Sorry, lack of commentary, but sometimes I pick a little better if I just kind of attack a lock and go for the feel. And but anyways, one's open for you. Let's take these spring covers off. Start with the right side. Two. Three on the right side. Four. Six. One on the right side. Two. Three. Not sure if you can see everything. I can't see. Four. Six. So there's your plug. It's got a little bit of over milling in there, which is probably why I had to rework a lot of those key pins up into their up into their chamber. Let's see if I can. So you've got pins at 9 o'clock and 3 o'clock. And this is where the little ball bearing sits to kind of hold everything in place. Let's see if you can see the overmilling. So on the left side, chamber one, you've got a little mushroom spool. Looks like that. It's got a little spot for the spring to sit inside. Whoops. Key pins look like. Got a tiny little taper at the top, which you have to kind of nudge into the, or out of the over milling. And you got another mushroom there, you got a standard here, you got a mushroom there, standard here, standard here. On the right hand side, you've got a standard mushroom. Standard mushroom. Standard mushroom. The housing. But pretty cool lock. Here's the key. This is my first dimple that I really got to experiment with, so it's been a bit of a learning curve for me. When I picked the lock, I kept turning it 45 degrees because that's kind of what I was used to doing, and I kept dumping the key pins inside the keyway there, at least from within the Bible. I would have at least one row of drivers and pins just kind of get all jacked up inside the keyway there. But yeah, a lot of fun. All right, guys, thanks for watching.